Hey everyone, this is Juana Lefter with NNC Services. I'm glad to be back with the daily video. We are about 2 months into the lockdown, and actually some countries are relaxing their measures today. We've heard about adapting to the new normal for quite a while, and apparently there are some particular technologies and trends that would play a significant role into this new normal in the following years. And one of them is actually augmented and virtual reality. Now, you may know a bit about how this went before COVID-19, but let's plunge into a particular study that shows a bit how could COVID-19 change the future of augmented and virtual reality. And I came over this article from VentureBeat, written by Tim Merrill, and it's based on a study from DG Capital. And there's an interesting graphic here that shows the short and medium-term impacts of COVID-19 on AR/VR. Obviously, the location-based entertainment has the highest negative impact, but there are some interesting positive impacts on other areas such as video, hardware sales, ad spend, e-commerce sales, enterprise, and app store. This is quite interesting. So actually, DigiCapital's long-term virtual and augmented reality forecast for AR/VR market is to reach around 65 billion revenue by 2024. So this is a study from before COVID-19. They may be an impact related to COVID-19 for the following a couple of years. Some are pros, some are cons. And let's look a bit in each particular sector impact. Now, the AR/VR hardware sales. Well, apparently physical lockdowns could be a plus for the AR/VR hardware demand as individuals and businesses look to stay connected during the crisis. However, the brick and mortar retail closures might be a net negative for. So it's a so-and-so impact. On the other hand, in terms of ad spend, apparently the mobile augmented reality advertising has seen much of relevant ad spend going towards traditional ad units viewed around user-generated mobile AR contacts, such as filters and lenses on messaging platforms. Physical lockdowns look at first blush like they should be positive for mobile AR advertising, as mobile messaging use has seen a significant uptick since the crisis started. Apparently, TikTok also has quite a significant impact on these figures. E-commerce sales. Well, apparently, the data on e-commerce impacts from COVID-19 have shown mixed results, so any uplift could be limited here. Enterprise, and this is an interesting sector because apparently people think a lot that AR and VR only impacts B2C. But for B2B, apparently physical lockdowns look like a plus for AR/VR enterprise software and services as companies try to find ways to get their internal and wider external teams to communicate, collaborate, find a path forward during the crisis. We're going to dip into the B2B AR and VR during the following days. Now, this Thursday, we are holding a free webinar brought to you by NNC and Alice Immersive Lab. Our friends from Alice Immersive Lab actually do strategy services and production services for XR, and they are quite good at this. So join us on Thursday to learn more about how will AR and VR shape the post-COVID-19 marketing. You'll learn about how to build your XR strategy, some VR storytelling principles, and you'll actually be able to find out how to start your first XR project. We also have some very interesting case studies from KFC and Das Bob Coffee Lab. So don't forget to register in the link below and join us on Thursday to learn more about AR/VR in marketing. See you soon.